Good morning, this is Nathan Mueller, the SDSU Extension Agronomist, and this morning we're going to be talking about how to take a leaf sample of a soybean plant for plant nutrient analysis. And the reason this is important is because with the fertility programs that we have and the value of the crop that we're growing here, soybeans, there's a way we can look at the quality control check. And one of those quality control checks for our fertility program or our fertilizer program is to look at how much nutrients are in soybean leaves. And it's very important that we take the right plant part at the right growth stage and send that into the lab in the right way. And so we're going to talk about how to do that today. And so that way the results that you get back as a crop consultant or producer or other person that's working with soybeans on plant analysis gets good results that are within the confines of the interpretation that we use for those nutrient analysis or the concentration of, for example, nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium that should be in these leaves if they're well fertilized. That way we can maximize our yield and have a profitable operation on your farm. And so the next part we're going to go to is identifying what growth stage the soybean's at today, and is it the correct stage? Something that we need to do to make sure we get a good plant sample is to take it at the right growth stage. And what we want is beginning to full bloom. So when you start to see flowers on your soybeans, that's a time you can start to go out and take samples of soybean leaves for plant nutrient analysis. And you can see here, we have a bloom right here. It's not all the way to the top node, so it's not at R2 or full bloom yet. But you know what? We have a range that we can take samples at from R2 beginning bloom to full bloom. What we have here now is we want to identify what part of the plant that we want to take. And so typically, it's the third uppermost trifoliate in the soybean plant. So here, one, two, and three. So there's options of these three, and guys often wonder what part of the plant to take. And so you can kind of look at these leaves. This one obviously is not developed yet. It's smaller than the two leaves below it. It's not fully developed, and we want the uppermost fully developed leaf. So not this one. You look at this one versus this, and you can see this is a little bit darker green. So again, one, two, three. The third trifoliate from the top is the part that we want to sample. So we want to break this off. And so now we have this part, and you can just, and you don't need to actually to pull the plant out. You can just go through and just rip this off of the plant. And the part that we want is not the petiole, but just the trifoliate. So you can break that off just with your fingers. It's really easy. This is the petiole. It's lower nutrient concentration than this. So if you send this, both of these parts into the lab, you'll get a lower concentration back, specifically zinc and manganese, for example. So what we want, you can discard this, and now you just have three leaf blades, and this is called a soybean leaf or soybean trifoliate. And what you want to do with these, you collect 30 of these from the field that you're interested in, and you put them in a paper bag. Just a brown paper bag that you can get from Walmart or any other store for sack lunch size. Open that up and you put 30 of these trifoliates in there. If you collect 30 of those, go ahead and just fold it shut and send it into the lab. And something you're going to bring with you besides is you're going to want to mark the bag for the lab to send in and have a magic marker with you. So this, for example, this is the Volga East field. So I went ahead and wrote Volga East and send this into your lab. Again, send it in a paper bag like this. Go ahead and box it up and send it to the lab of your choice. You should get your results back typically within a week. That shows the nutrient concentration of these soybean leaves in this field. And with that will come an interpretation of those results. And because you took the leaf sample, the correct plant part, just the trifoliate without the petal at the right growth stage, you're going to get some very good results back, so you can use those results to improve your soil fertility program and make sure that you're meeting the needs of your soybean plants with your fertilizer program. So again, real quick in summary, you want to collect these soybean plants, the third uppermost trifoliate, so roughly one, two, three, take this off, send this part into the lab, put it in a paper bag, send 30 of these into the lab, you should get your results back within a week, and you can then use this to have a good quality control check for your fertility program. So this is a summary of how to take soybean plant analysis or soybean plant tissue analysis so we know that you have the right amount of nutrients in your fields here in South Dakota.